Behram Bhai was discharged from the hospital 10 days after the operation. We all went to Bombay in the morning of 16th October. The wedding took place the same evening, and the third day we all returned to Pune. After our marriage, I had told Baba once before that, "Baba, I wanted to settle down in Pune and did not want to go back to my place of work, and that was Bangalore. My transfer was there in the month of December, and Baba called me and said, 'You go to Bangalore. I like it and you will enjoy yourself in Bangalore.' So Gulnar and I moved to Bangalore in December, and we really had a jolly good time. Gulnar was in the hospital for a couple of months and we came back to Pune in the month of February. After we, and all the money that we had got during our marriage, we had taken with us, and we came back from Bangalore with a couple of rupees in our pockets, having spent all the amount in Bangalore for medical aid, hospitalization, finding a house, and so on and so forth. After we came back, we met Baba at Guru Prasad the same summer, and Baba asked me, "Jangu, how did you like Bangalore?" I said, "Baba, we had a very, very tough time." Baba said, "Well, whatever has happened according to the will of God, so don't worry and be happy." Then we thought of this project that Behram Bhai and I should take films of beloved Baba whenever Baba would give us a chance. So Baba agreed that whenever he would give darshan or whenever there was a chance, he had no objection if we took the films, the 16mm movie. So we would all prepare ourselves with flood lamps, cameras, rolls, and we would get ready to take the 16mm movie. The moment I would switch on the flood lamps, Baba would make a face and he said, "My God, these people have come to distract my attention. Don't want to sit down," Baba would say, you see. And we would sit down. And this kept on happening all along. And of course, we took quite a lot of Baba films. Another incident which happened, very amusing, I should say. Van Gaston was to go to Mehr Azad to take films of beloved Baba washing the feet of the lepers. Behram Bhai and I also went to Mehrabad with our camera because we were called that Baba would allow us to take films. After we went to Mehrabad, suddenly Baba said, "Look, I don't want Van Gaston to be disturbed when he is taking my film. So I'm sure you all will not take my films when he is taking my film." We had gone all the way to Mehrabad for taking a very important event, that is Baba washing the feet of the lepers. And according to Baba's orders, we sat down. But then Baba, so compassionate and kind that he is, gave us another chance in the afternoon after Van Gaston had taken the film and conducted the leper feet washing program all over just for our sake. And we took quite a few rolls of that particular event. And of course, another incident which I would like to mention, although normally I wouldn't mention to people around. It's my conviction, maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm right. It so happened that it was on a Christmas day, I was walking with little Mehrwan, and there was a crib of Christ put up by the people. It was the Christmas day. As I was just passing the crib, I suddenly saw a very friendly smile, a person approaching me with a friendly smile, wanting to wish me. He came close to me, extending both his hands, And I was trying to recollect who the person was. I just couldn't recollect. But then his smile was so catching that I just couldn't help. I extended my hands. He touched my hands in this fashion and patted little Mehrwan on his cheeks and passed us. Just half a minute after he passed us, something struck me very fiercely at the back of my mind, and I said, who is the person? I wheeled back just to find out. I wanted to go and meet the person and ask him, may I know your name? But then half a minute afterwards, I just couldn't trace the person. Somehow there was such a great feeling in me that I had definitely, it was beloved Baba and nobody else. And it was a very difficult thing to say definitely, but the feeling in me definitely says that it couldn't be anybody else. I came back home and tried to see different pictures of Baba, trying to figure out which picture matched the person I had met near the crib.
Little incident which I am going to say, happened many years ago before Baba's accident. My mummy and my twin brothers had gone to Bombay, and my elder brother was sleeping in this main room, and in the other room my daddy and myself were sleeping. My uncle Jal was in his room. Suddenly, in the middle of the night, it was exactly 2 o'clock, we heard a loud knock, and my daddy rushed to see who it was, and it was beloved Baba. He at once instructed my father Bayram that please. Now, my father went to see who it was, and it was beloved Baba. He was very surprised, and Baba said, I have some very important work to do, but please tell Gulnar, that's myself, and my brother Sheriar, that they should sleep and close their eyes and not even look at him. He went straight to his room, and then he asked my father that please tell Gulnar to prepare some tea and hot water. I was very much tempted to have a glimpse of him, and I think it was only Bilal Baba who helped me to keep his orders. After about an hour or so, he left. Then after a few days, my mummy and her brothers returned from Bombay, and the same thing happened. Baba again visited us, and he said the same thing, that no one should look at him except Bayram, that's my father, and my uncle Jal. And he again asked us to prepare some tea and some hot water, and what he did in the room, none of us know. My husband will take over.
I hope I'm not taking up much of your tape, but then one incident I remember, I think I should mention it here.
Excuse
me. Yes. It was December 5th, 15 days before Dara's wedding. Dara, you know Dara, Baba's brother's son. I was there at Mehrazad for some work, and Baba asked me, what was the work? Then I told Baba that I had come in connection with some work regarding the 16 millimeter movies to be discussed with Mani. And then we spent the usual time with beloved Baba in the hall at Mehrazad, and it was time for Baba to go back to his quarters with the women Mandali. Baba tried to get up from the chair, and it so happened that he was not able to get up, and he sat back with quite a bit of, sort of a very heavy feeling. He sat back in the chair. It so happened that as a reflex action, I bit my finger, thinking perhaps Baba has become very weak. Just as I thought of that, Baba did that, and he said, come, I want to shake hands with you and see how strong I am. And the way he pressed my hand, my God, I just couldn't believe it. I told Baba, definitely Baba, you are very strong. A small incident, but very interesting. I always had a problem, and that was regarding my work. Originally, I was working at Bangalore, and when I came to Pune and got married, my only wish was that I should settle down in Pune. And Baba would always say, don't worry, keep looking for a job in Pune, leave the rest to me. Year after year, number of interviews and applications, every time we would write to Baba, Baba would say, don't worry, leave all to me. And it so happened that the place where I was working closed down at Pune, and Baba did help me to find another job. But then for once I thought that perhaps it was like going from the frying pan into the fire. And the second job which I took kept me on my toes, because every second day there was a threat of retrenchment and my name was up on the list. So every time this topic came up of retrenchment, I would write a long letter to Baba. Retrenchment. Retrenchment, removal of people from the factory because of less work. So every time this topic came up, I was shuddering and jittery and upset. I would write to Baba. Baba would always say that, look, don't worry, be happy. And a number of years passed that way. Ultimately, I did land a very good job in Pune. So Baba would always crack a joke, tell me, Jangu, even if you have problems of the whole world on your head, your cheeks are not going to go in, so you don't worry. Well, in reply to your question, if Baba said anything about drugs, Rustam, Baba's nephew, one of the twins, was present at Guru Prasad when Baba did mention about people taking drugs. Well, Rustam.
Well, there was a discussion going about Americans consuming drugs. Well, I remember distinctly Baba had said that if Americans continue taking drugs heavily or regularly, they would either go mad or commit suicide. This is why I've heard very distinctly, and even my brother-in-law was there present when Baba had said this.
Yes, I do remember Baba saying that by taking drugs they will achieve nothing as far as the spiritual path is concerned. The only thing is that perhaps a person would go mad and perhaps commit suicide.
Do you remember anything else, Rustam, that Baba had said about drugs?
No, I don't remember anything more, but these words did strike me.
What did he say?
I don't remember anything more about it, but this sentence did really strike me, and it's still ringing in my head.
I remember regarding manifestation, Baba having said at Guru Prasad that when he manifests, he will appear at 1,000 different places physically.
Heard that too?
Yes.
Rustam, did you hear that?
Yes, I heard
you
it.
You were there, I'm sure.
Yes, I was there. Jai Baba.
I think I always pray that we keep holding on to beloved Baba's Dhamman, because that was what Baba used to say when he was physically present. But the importance of that, perhaps we know now how difficult it would be if we are not alert. Jai Baba.